The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures, where he gives me repose. Near as for waters he leads me, to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, with these you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head will be ever anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the book of Revelation. And I, John, heard a voice from heaven saying, write this: blessed are the dead who from now on die in the Lord. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we don't know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a while. On behalf of the faithful parishioners of the Immaculate Conception Cathedral Parish, I would like to extend our deepest condolences to all of you, the bereaved family, especially to Gerald, to Carl and Nancy, to Sian and Elaine, to Karen Marie and Dines, to Matthew, Jonathan, Brandon, CJ, to Nicole, Casey, to Tyler, to Elaine, Dylan, to Dwight, to Cara Marie, to Zachary, to the great-grandchildren, Caleb, Carter, Griffin, Rowan, to Gerald, to Eric, to the nephews, nieces, to the relatives and friends. Again, our deepest condolences. Brothers and sisters, we find ourselves mourning in the midst of all the excitement of Christmas. We have the sadness of our grief, combined with the symbols of hope of the Christmas season. Decorated trees and waiting tombs are not the kinds of things we typically associate with each other. But friends, we all know why the Christ child lay in a manger. He came to save us. He came to give us life. He came to recreate us anew. He came to pay the wages of sin and to take on our death at the cross. And because he lives, we too, dear friends, shall also live. Brothers and sisters, like all believers, your mom, your grandma, your great-grandma, Joan Marie, Joan Marie was imprinted with the very cross of Christ at her holy baptism. And that means that being made a disciple of Jesus Christ, one of the redeemed and ransomed, one for whom our blessed Lord has taken to himself in heaven, one who has been given eternal life. For as the familiar passage in John 3 in the scripture says, God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. So friends, this is the meaning of Christmas, and it is the meaning of Christianity. Brothers and sisters, no matter how pious a person is, no matter how beloved he or she has been in this life, no one is perfect. Your mom is a good mom, a good friend, a good grandma, great grandma, but no one is perfect. And that, dear friends, that is the reason why the Lord God provided a Savior. He provided Joan with a Savior for her salvation. Joan was not perfect, but today she is. Like the rest of us, she had to see in the mirror dimly, but now she sees with clarity, face to face with God himself. Formerly, she was burdened with limitations and imperfections. But today, she has come through all of that, standing like Isaiah in the wondrous presence of the God who gave his only begotten Son as his sacrifice and atonement for her. So again, congratulations. Though I know that there is that sadness in your faces, she's gone, but she will be there. And she will always be connected to you in her heart, in her prayers. And brothers and sisters, eternal grace unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shed upon her, may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Please all stand. Together as one family of faith, we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Brothers and sisters, Jesus, our Savior, has gone before us and prepared a place for us in our Father's house. We now place our trust in him and say, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
For Joan Marie, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of saints. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them into the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Joan Marie seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here and via live stream in faith and confidence to pray for our sister, Joan Marie. Strengthen our hope that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for our sister Joan Marie. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Joan Marie again and enjoy her friendship. Brothers and sisters, in baptism, our sister Joan Marie shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. We shall be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. Friends, as a sign of respect for our sister Joan Marie, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Joan Marie as your certain hope, that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Blessed are those who have died in Christ. Let them rest from their labor, for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. Mary's soul and the souls of all the faithful departed to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
The recessional hymn can be found in your Glory and Praise, number 178, On Eagle's Wings. My rock and home, I
you.